Old, I think the ground's gonna rise up to meet you, and I'm just gonna start doing this, and how come the people aren't coming up?
Yeah, I can probably for me, because after the 2012 election cycle, there were a lot of men getting credit. And I was just so mad at that, because that just wasn't true. That's like not the way Obama went. The volunteers were women, the 3 deputy campaign managers, and the political director were all women, and the people under them were getting the credit. And so I did like a tweet storm, I don't know why this was having in Twitter, but I did a tweet storm that was like, here are 10 women that you shouldn't be putting in your articles instead of these same old white dudes. And most of them were like, most of the white dudes reported to these women. And I was like, I went away and I came back. I had hundreds of notifications on Twitter. All my friends were tagging me on Facebook, and it was like she said what everybody's been thinking. I wasn't anybody special when I came in. I was like a junior staffer. I realized then that courage and the truth always have resonance. And that sort of helped me realize that I was never going to get what I wanted if I just kept my head down and worked hard, which is a theme that happens in particular to Latino communities, frankly. Just keep your head down. Don't let them notice you. And I was like, I don't want to get it. I want to get noticed.
Come on. I love it. Anyone else have a wait your turn moment where you decided? I know Andrew, you and I haven't even talked about this. You were saying, I have this idea, I feel like I gotta do this, but surely someone else is doing that. Sorry, what was the feeling for you about making that decision?
I kept looking for, I had a lot of new friends, were calling me and saying, how do I get involved in the wake of the election, and what do I do? And then I didn't have anywhere to send them, where do I put my dollars, and things like that. And past some of the usual suspects, I couldn't help them to do anything new and innovative with their money and ways to invest in grassroots organizations and invest in the resistance. And so I just kept looking for who I could connect them to, and who I could, and I wanted to be in service of another organization that did such a thing, and I realized it wasn't going to happen unless I did it. So that was the moment I think that I stood up and just decided to go ahead and do what needs to be done. And I think, at a certain point, there's always something that pushes you to have enough, and when you have enough, you engage and you step up.
Because so many people don't make a decision, and I think we always talk about leadership, and it's like I'm going to go to school, I'm going to get a degree, I'm going to have the perfect strategy, I'm going to go to training, someone's going to mentor me, and it's an inside game. It's so much leadership is an inside game. It's a decision, it's an inside game, and I think we have to say that out loud. It can't just be about, look at this amazing thing I've done, and I'm perfectly coiffed, and was perfectly prepared, and I just don't meet leaders if that was their story, but I feel like people don't say that enough, especially young people, so good on you. Anyone else, a last, wait your turn moment to see people, everyone can say if you have a quick answer, do it.
I have a funny answer. So the organization that became Vote.org was my side hustle for 7 years, which I probably didn't mention. I think we became Vote.org before we had any staff members.
You used to post pictures on Facebook of your cat and say it was the CFO.
If you actually look at the Vote.org org chart, there is in fact a cat and then everyone else. We just find that it helps with leadership. But it's actually a funny side story. So this was my side project, and in 2012, my side project, which was then called Long Distance Voter, registered 100,000 people on $1,300. And no one ever told me that I had just finished running one of the country's biggest voter registration drives. I had a day job, so I had no idea, and I figured if we did that on $1,300, then obviously everyone with human staff who didn't have day jobs had run a much bigger program, and someone mentioned it in passing once. It was NOI, there was an organization that was verifying everyone's number, and they called me about the typo in the thing that I submitted with our